Hey guys, welcome back to another video. This is Motivation Beyond Christians. Welcome back. Today, I'll be showing you the clip of me preaching in Guyana. I was in Guyana for a little bit, and I was able to preach at the church that I grew up in, where I found my faith and my love of God. And I just want to show you guys it, because it's my first time preaching in Guyana.
As some of you may know, my name is Esron Holder. I was born right here in Guyana, raised until I was the age of 9, and attended this church for those 9 years. While growing up here at a young age, I was constantly trying to find my gift, my purpose, and my God-given ability. And I said to myself, when I find this gift, I have to come to Fort Detroit to use this gift for the Lord. And later in my life, I discovered that my gift was a gift of speech and preaching and motivation and speaking. And today, I finally get to fulfill that promise to myself and preach to you guys. So, Pastor, thank you so much for this opportunity. Today I will be speaking on why trials and tribulations are important. In Romans chapter 12, verse 12, it says, "Rejoice in our confident hope. Be patient in trouble and keep on praying." In life we are met with trials and tribulations, but God allowed those trials and tribulations to happen for a reason. One thing I've learned in my life about serving God is that God allowed trials and tribulations to happen for 3 reasons. To make you stronger, to teach you a lesson, or both. And trials and tribulations does with that. You either learn a lesson, the situation may be stronger, or both. In James chapter 1, verse 2, it says, "Dear brothers and sisters, when trouble of any kind comes your way, consider it a great opportunity for good. When you go through your trials and tribulations, it may not seem like it will make you stronger or a lesson will be learned. But you always have to remember it. But God said he will never leave us nor forsake us. Through your trials and tribulations, you may feel angry, sad, annoyed, discouraged, which is okay. But don't forget, God is always with you and is always looking good at the end of your trials and tribulations." In 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 18, it says, "Be thankful in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you who know Jesus Christ." I'm very thankful for all trials and tribulations that I've been throughout my life, but the one that I'm most thankful for is my bullying experience, which I experienced from a period of 6 years, from 2011 to 2018. Once I first migrated to the United States of America in 2012, at the age of 9, I first encountered bullying. I enrolled in the 4th grade and bullying started immediately. I was a skinny, dark-skinned boy with a matching accent, and my fellow classmates in the grade made fun of me for that, for being skinny, for my skin color, and more. I was very different from the other 4th graders, and that gave them a reason to bully me. My experience with bullying first got physical in the 4th grade and proceeded in later years. I was spit on, slapped, jumped, beat up on, and 2 students came to my house to fight me. It was very difficult going to school each and every day. Being physically and mentally abused, but I pushed through. I did experience some bullying in middle school and ended up becoming a bully who, to me, being bullied, but I was able to recognize my wrong ways and change myself. In high school, I didn't experience any bullying and I was no longer a bully. My experience with bullying shaped the person I am today. While I was experiencing bullying, I didn't have anyone to talk to me about it or handle it, and I had to cheer up myself by being a bully. And as a Christian, I know that God allows situations to happen for us to grow and to change that. My bullying experience did both. I learned to enjoy being myself, and it helped me grow. I read the Bible and talked to myself on a daily basis to handle my situation. And in 2015, at the age of 12, I created my YouTube channel to start helping kids who are being bullied in order to help them move forward each and every single day. Making my YouTube videos is where I found my gift of speech and continued to use it in many aspects. My main channel, Motivation for Young Christians, which I've been running for over 6 years now. On this channel, I make motivational videos for Christians on topics such as temptation, fear, forgiveness, and more, all designed to help young Christians live out their purpose to the fullest. My second channel, Motivation for Students, which I've been running for 1 year now. I make motivational videos for students on topics such as bullying, being yourself, reaching for your goals, and more. All designed to help students achieve success inside and outside of school. My bullying experience did came with many positives, but also negatives. As a result, I suffered from PTSD, post-traumatic stress disorder, and a traumatized kid who was inherited in pain, And I have many, many good wounds with my experiences. I seek help from my mentors, I read my Bible, and pray every day to help you with my healing process. My healing process has been difficult, but I continue to push through. Today, I'm a 17-year-old Christian, a creator, a graphic designer, a videographer, an editor, a YouTuber, a preacher, a motivational speaker, a CEO, and founder of the Motivation Team of Christians. And the CEO of the Founder Motivation for Students. For me today is confident, fearless, and outspoken, and it's all because of my bullying experience. I'm very thankful for it because it made me the person I am today. I'm going back to the first of the 18. Be thankful in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you. And again, today I will be able to fulfill my promise of preaching to the church where I found my faith, where I fell in love with God. And thank you so much for this opportunity, Pastor. And church, I love you from the bottom of my heart, because without Guyana, without 4C Church, there won't be any me. Amen.
Hey guys, I finished the preaching for today. This was such an amazing experience to be able to preach in Guyana. This is my first time preaching in Guyana. Y'all know Guyana is home. Also, I got to preach at the church that I grew up in with a faith, and my love for God began. So it was just an amazing experience to be able to preach. I got a lot of positive feedback, and we're going to continue to excel, learn more, and just improving all the areas that we can when it comes to my preaching ability and just everything else. I'm just so thankful for the opportunity to be able to preach, and I love it so much.
Yeah, this is kind of like days after, well, exactly a week after I preached at 4C Church for the first time, which marked my first time speaking in Guyana, my first time speaking at that church, and that experience was just such an amazing experience. And I know I did an intro before I spoke, then I did an outro after it, but I just loved that moment so much, and I just enjoyed it so much. And whilst I'm down here, everybody's just telling me and then my brothers and sisters just how proud they are of us, because our parents gave us the opportunity by taking us over to America and telling us, okay, we gave you the opportunity, now it's your choice to do what you want with it. And even though I had a little rough patch and stuff with me getting into trouble and all of that, I turned it around. I turned it around, and I'm doing so good right now. And academic-wise, school-wise, behavior-wise, I don't get in trouble no more. I just continue to be a narrow path, just following God and just letting Him use me and being able to do all of that. And I just love it so much, and everybody just love that so much, because they know me. Like, I've been bad since I was a child. I was bad down here, and then I got even worse when I went over to America. But they are just so proud of me that I completely changed around, and I'm just doing very good. And also, they proud that we took advantage of the opportunity, because with us going over there, we heard about how when parents take their kids over to like America, how they end up either getting involved with street life, gang banging, selling drugs, robbing people, and end up going to jail. Then some people get deported back. So they made us fully aware of that, of how a bunch of the people with the opportunity, they just went left with it. So everybody was just hoping that we didn't follow down that same path. And we just took advantage of the opportunity and just make the most out of it. And we did it. And even though I got in trouble, I didn't get into no legal trouble. I don't have any record, never been arrested, never been jailed. I have no mugshot, never got involved in the street life or nothing like that. My trouble was just mainly like school, church, like just at home trouble. There was never anything legal. And I always be so thankful for that. I'm like, I'm glad I only got into those type of trouble instead of legal trouble, because with American system over there, they're not forgivable once you got a record, because it's already hard enough being black in America, but then you black with a record, you just making a situation worse. It's like you being black in America, it's like you're in the hot water, in a pot, and the water's boiling. You having a record, it's like you hopping right into the frying pan. And it just makes it so bad for me. I'm just so glad that I never got into that I'm straight. And I was just sitting here just reflecting, because I know this whole vlog video will be posted on my birthday. I'm just so thankful for this opportunity. I just always like coming down here because this is always a humbling experience for me, just to be able to see again where I grew up and just be so thankful. And I just love it. I just be so amazed. Like, I was in Guyana April, and then I was in Guyana again in June, and both times when I was coming from the airport heading to the house, I was just looking out to and just say, thank God, thank God. Just to know how blessed I am, because it's not many people get the opportunity to be able to go over there and just have a better life. Like, I have a whole bunch of family over here, and we got that opportunity, and I just glad that we made the most out of our opportunity. We made the best for ourselves, and I just love it, because I just want to make them proud, make my family proud here. I make my family proud in America, because I got family in a whole bunch of different countries. So I just want to make everybody just proud. And I'm just glad that I'm doing that right now. I'm making them proud, and I love it so much, the fact that I'm making them proud. And I completely love it. And I always acknowledge the fact that I'm Guyanese. I always rep the country so much. Yeah, and the reason why I love Guyanese so hard and always like to tell people that I'm Guyanese, just because I'm very proud of where I'm from. I'm very proud of growing up here, and just the country as a whole. I'm proud, and I'm proud of where I'm from. And then also the second reason is just to pay homage to my family. Both my mother and my father's side are from here, were born here. So with me always repping it is because I'm proud of where I'm from, is just to pay homage to my family, because I didn't want to move over to America and just completely forgot that I was born here. Like, I spent the first 9 years of my life here. I didn't want to do that. I just wanted to always have that remembrance of I was born here. I'm from here. So I love the country so hard, because I love my country. I love where I was born. I love where I'm from. So I just always make sure I rep the country to the fullest. Anytime I get to rep it, I make sure I rep it. I just love where I'm from. And this video was just such an amazing video for me, just being able to fulfill the promise that I made to myself at the age of, I think, 5 or 6. I made that promise to myself to use my time here. I just saw a bunch of stuff, because God have a lot of things in store for me. Me, myself, I don't even know. I know I got some stuff planned, but I know the guy got stuff planned too, so we'll see what the future holds. But just know I'll be great whatever I put my mind to. And same thing with you. Just continue, to everybody that's watching, continue to be great. Continue to be appreciative for the things that you have, the place that you live. Always thank God. You're blessed, not lucky. You're blessed. Just always remember that. I'm just happy that I'm dropping this on my 18th birthday, which marks 9 years in Guyana, 9 years in America. And I just appreciate it. The day 18 been wonderful, and I love it so much. And I'm an adult, 18. 18, yeah. Still can't believe I'm 18, but I am. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you guys for coming along on this journey with me. Just talking, wherever you're from, whether it's the Caribbean or the Americas or any other foreign country, wherever you're from, big up to all the Caribbean people, all the American people, and everybody else. Continue to enjoy. Peace. Bye. This was it for the video, guys. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. Thank you guys so much. If you haven't already, like the video, subscribe if you're new, please turn on your post notification. That way, anytime I upload a video, YouTube will send your notification. This is Motivation for Young Christian. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.